There are illegal retrenchment happening in IT industry each and every year. The companies, the IT companies name that as layoffs. This is nothing but to maximize their profit margin. For example, CTS has announced layoff last year. When we see the annual report of CTS, it was about 4.1% growth when we compare to previous year. The company is not in loss. It was in steady growth, but still the company wants to lay off the employees. They say that as a fit for growth plan 2020. This is nothing but a method of doing cost cutting to show increase in their profit, which is illegal. For this year again, they have started doing layoffs in many cities in India. We can see many employees in Chennai are started complaining that the company is forcing them to resign. And not only CTS, IBM has announced, Infosys has announced, Accenture has forced more than 900 employees working in India to resign.
Now it is entering into another phase where the large MNCs are getting into the phase of retrenchments. So to understand this in depth, we need to understand how the dynamics of the Indian IT industry is working. So none of these companies were posting any losses before COVID. It was not like other industries where they were performing bad and they were in a situation to bankruptcy or any other such situations were there for Indian IT companies. Most of the mid-level and large MNCs were in making a much larger profit than any other industries in India. So in such situations, why this is happening? We need to understand it in depth. So if you see the Indian IT industry to maintain their profit and to increase the profit maximization in this periods of crisis, as everyone knows that Indian IT industry is more dependent on outsourcing economy of America and Europe. So since the pandemic affected the entire globe, it has impacted the entire industries of the world. So there is a large business drop across the globe. But still, what the experts in industry say is that even though the traditional business of service is affected, still the customers are preferring to fast-track the activities of digital transformation. So digital transformation in the sense is moving towards cloud, introducing AI ML in their enterprise. So such activities have been fast-tracked across the client scenarios in Europe and America. So the business is not weakened for Indian IT industry, but still this Indian companies, startup or a mid-level or the MNCs, taking this COVID as a chance to retrench their highly paid employees, and also taking this as a chance to downsize their workforce in India. And at the same time, you can see how to substance my point. If you take the each company statement, they are ready to recruit new recruitments from colleges. At the same time, they are retrenching. So this is both contradictory stuff. So in case if there is a crisis across industry, then you would see a scenario of no intake of employees also. But the scenario is different where any company, even the latest CTS was going to retrench more than 18,000 employees, saying that they are going to recruit fresh graduates from colleges. So in such scenarios, I think the current crisis is not about COVID. It's about the profit maximization of Indian IT industry. So either be a small company or a mid company or a large company, they don't want to bear the pain of the COVID and retain their employees for this period. They just want to downsize them and increase the profit maximization. So that's the intention of them. So current crisis of CTS. So CTS, if you see the CTS last couple of years, they are under crisis. Okay. A few years back, they had some financial statement issues where which a few VPs were fired. And after that, they had an issue of the Siriseri CTS building scam, where the government officials from Tamil Nadu were given a large amount of bribe to build that complex. So such things were continuously happening with CTS for a long time. And retrenchment which has been spoken now is just a continuation of the activities which they are continuing for the last couple of years. Few years back, they were retrenched around 4,000 VPs and EVPs. And last year, they were downsized around 6,000 employees and majorly from the content management team. And today, this year, they have said around 18,000 employees. And this has been challenged by the trade unions at all the levels from various states. And we have raised this concern with the respective labor unions and respective ministries multiple times. The most important thing to understand in the CTS issue is the statement given by the CTS management. So the CTS management came and said that so this downsizing is part of their normal activity of performance management. And they never rejected the claim that it is not firing, there is no retrenchment or something like that, that is not happening, they never said it. So they are accepting that there is some retrenchment is going on. So this is itself a clear statement where government need to intervene and they need to address the issue of the CTS employees. And why it is a major problem? Because around 18,000 employees of Indian employees are going to lose their job, and they are, if they lose the job, it is going to affect the subsequent economical activities of India. So that is a chain reaction is going to happen.
Okay. Central government, by now, I expect them to understand and analyze the issues in this IT industry, but even I don't have much hope on this government, but still, government at the center should have taken note of the situation, because nearly 92% of our work is coming from the onshore, and throughout the world, if this pandemic has affected, and as we all know, America is the first place that got affected worst. So central government should take note of this, and it has to regulate the work that we get in. And the central government has to understand the situation now. It has to understand the economy, and if it is the right time to increase the domestic work of IT industry is what I believe. Already I could see that many unions, especially KTU in Bangalore and Unite in Tamil Nadu, has taken some steps towards creating awareness among the employees to not to resign and to ask for their rights. So that is one way by which we can contact our employees and create an awareness on one thing. The second thing is the registered union, we have the right to notify the company that what they are doing is against the law, and it should be taken prior permission, or we can notify the government that this is not the way. And I've also seen that some notification has been presented to the labor commissioner in Chennai as well as in Bangalore, but that has to be continued. And we know the time at which all these government things take, but it's not a time where we can wait, because more than 3,500 employees has been lost their jobs, and this is not the time where we can wait. So all these actions have to be scrutinized, and it has to be fastened up, and whichever way we will be able to do it, if we have to take the help of the judiciary, we should be able to do it. We have to take the help of executives, we should be able to do it. So at this time, layoff at any time is not good, but at this time it is draconian, because people do not have anything other than this. They can't even go to other companies and take an interview, because no one else is conducting an interview at this time. So this is the time when we have to take care of ourselves. At this time, if someone is taking advantage of this situation and trying to make some benefit out of it for their own, that is not at all acceptable. That have to be taken care. And I guess some unions are in the right place, and they are doing the right steps. They are taking the right steps against this. And I wish they continue this.
So central government gave a lot of subsidies, and there are a lot of Indian IT companies in work from home. In tax subsidies, even from land subsidy, everything was given for Indian IT companies. Even now, Indian IT Ministry has given a circular to NASSCOM to come up with a legal framework for all work from home. So that much freedom is given to the companies. But never ever the central government assured that this would be given at a promise of that no employment will be lost. Central government is not worried about the employment aspect or the employees' concern. they are more worried about the cap list and the Indian IT company owners. So whose interest is to profit maximize by downsizing the employees in the company. The need of the hour is central government need to put in a checkpoint saying that if you need all the benefits from the government, you should ensure that there is no job loss or no retrenchment in the companies. That part is missing from the central government. And from the respective state governments, as the average from the state list, it's the duty of the state government need to put a strict guidelines that any labor complaints reaching the labor department that need to be acted upon within the framework of 30 days. And it need to be resolved within 30 days. Because at this juncture, we are there are more than hundreds of complaints of keep on coming to us for pay cuts and job losses. So immediately the labor department need to be responsive. And the second thing is the state governments need to arrange for a tri-party discussion with the companies, along with the unions, along with the labor officials. So this tri-party is very critical for the understanding between the unions and the employers and the government. So this understanding is very critical for resolving the current crisis revolving around COVID. So that is very critical. So this aspect is most required from the state governments, and also a strict guidelines from the state government to all the MNCs that during this COVID, any retrenchment that will be dealt with a serious consequence that need to be set to the MNCs.
In my knowledge, the only way the corporates or the capitalists can earn money is by cutting down the wages of the workers. So that too in a large scale. When you cut down the wage of worker in a large scale, obviously you're going to make a much profit than earlier. So this is going to happen. This is not the first case, and this is certainly not going to be the last case. The one thing that we have to be sure is that when we are in such a situation, what are the things that we need to follow? And if we come out of that situation for a brief period of time, what is that we have to do in future to avoid such cases? And if at all something is imposed on us, then where to approach help, whom to contact for support, all these things if we get to know, or all these things if the people who are really working on this feels like many organizing unions and other people, if they are able to bring it to the people in a large number, in a large scale, then I think there will be a not bigger difference, but there will be a minimal difference in that field. But anyway, this is a tactics that they are using, this corporates are using for a quite long time. And in this pandemic, they will quite easily do this. They will definitely do this, and they will do this in a very frequent manner in a large scale. So we have to be prepared for that.
At this scenario, we request the CTS employees to come forward for a collective struggle. And I want to quote an example here. Around 3,000 employees from CTS who have been downsized during the content management team closure have filed a lawsuit against CTS. And the combined value of that lawsuit is around 2.5 billion. Okay. So if employees come together, and if you feel that the retrenchment need to be is illegal and it need to be addressed, then CTS employees who need to come forward as a collectively raise the voice against this illegal retrenchment. So I even give this as a call for the CTS employees who have been retrenched and who have been left out from the company to come forward. So we will collectively raise the voice against this illegal retrenchment.